Do you know that almost 70% of the nutrients supplied to our crops will not be used by the plants? And most of it will be washed away by water going to aquifers. Today, I will go to the company NutriControl in Cartagena to speak with a precision agriculture and plant nutrition expert in order to know how to save money while protecting the environment. Here with Juan Pablo. He's an expert in precision agriculture and plant nutrition, and he will talk to us about the most advanced technologies in plant nutrition nowadays. Please, Juan Pablo, tell us, it is true that you can lose up to 70% of the nutrients we supply to our crops?
Yes, Francisco. We did find in some cases that farmers were losing up to 70% of nutrients they use, and this is a lot of money. I don't need to tell to every farmer how much they can spend in nutrients. But I am sure if you tell them that they can reduce 30 or 40% of nutrients they are using on their installation, they will be very happy, because saving costs in order to be more efficient is a strategy that they all are looking for.
But if you supply less nutrients, will you reduce your yield?
Just the opposite. You can expect the same or even higher yield in spite of the reduction on supply nutrients.
And how can you get the same yield with less nutrients?
Many farmers are using solid nutrients and they apply them once or twice a year. Others inject fertilizers and they apply them once a week. And others inject it just for 20 minutes while they are irrigating for 3 hours. That means they are supplying fertilizer to much concentrate. The effect on the plant is a hydraulic stress when it receives too much fertilizers, too much nutrients concentrated at once. So after the fertilizer is washed away, the plant will not have enough nutrients on the soil to grow properly.
I see, it is like water. The plant needs water every day. An ideal situation will be to receive a small amount of fertilizer along the whole irrigation time.
Correct. The issue used to be that with all irrigation system, applying a small amount of fertilizer every day was expensive and not easy to be done. But now, with drip irrigation and automated fertilization system, we can inject a small amount of fertilizer on a continuous way during the whole irrigation time, without extra effort.
But if you inject fertilizers every day, how can you reduce the amount of nutrients?
Because you will supply to the plant the nutrients it requests in the current day, no more, no less. And then, the day after, you will supply the nutrients that the plant needs that day. Like that, we will reduce to the maximum the amount of nutrients that are not going to be used in the plant. Our target is that every single gram of nutrients we inject will be absorbed by the plant.
Yes, I can find a lot of similarities with irrigation. I presume that you will reduce also the losses of fertilizer because you will apply them only where the root of our crops are and not away.
Yes, correct. I saw your video and you explained it very clearly.
Interesting. But tell me, how do you determine the correct amount of fertilizer to be supplied every day?
It is very important to know the nutritional needs of the plant. It's the agronomist who must determine the tolerance limits of the crop. Limits of electrical conductivity, for example. According to those limits, we can determine the total amount of fertilizers, of nutrients, to be applied depending on the phenological stage of the plant. It is important to avoid exceed the limits in which we can affect the development of the plant. It can affect the growing of the plant, the quality of our yield, or even in very extreme cases, the plant can die. To help us to know the electrical conductivity in our soils, our automatic fertigation equipment can be connected to sensors on the ground and meteor station. Easy sensors allow us to know, measure and modify the fertigation recipe depending on easy values on the soil and water volumetric content. The meteor sensors like soil radiation sensor also provide us important information to determine the amount of fertilizer depending on solar radiation. When solar radiation is high, over 600 up to 900 watts per square meter, the photosynthetic rate will be lower, and for that, the nutrients consumption will be lower as well.
Amazing! That means that you will be injecting fertilizers almost the whole time you are irrigating.
Almost yes. You must consider that at the same time we are injecting nutrients, we are having the control of pH and EC on the solution.
Automatically?
Yes, of course. It is important for several reasons. On the other hand, on one hand, you will control the pH of your water network and avoid chemical precipitation and organic matter growing that can damage the system. But on the other hand, you will supply the irrigation water with the correct pH and EC to make it easier for the plant to absorb all the nutrients. You need to notice that some nutrients will not be available to the plant if the pH is out of a certain value, and we can control the pH in order to make it easier to the plant to absorb them.
It must be very difficult to control that many parameters.
It is very easy, in fact, because our equipment can do it automatically. And the farmers don't need to do nothing at all. They can even see what is happening in their farms, see it on their sofa. Every data collected by our system can be sent to the cloud, and the farmer can see all of them through our mobile application. This is what we call digital farming.
They are all advantages, but now please tell me a little bit about these losses by percolation, because sustainability is now a very important factor.
Well, you know that we are more and more concerned about the environment and how each or action will affect to it. And the farmers are also concerned. In this case, it is not like water. If the water you are supplying is not used by your crop, you will lose a lot of money. But the water will evaporate or will percolate, and nothing happens. Nutrients are different. They stay on the soil until they get washed by rainwater, and they percolate along with this water reaching aquifers, causing, in some cases, what is called eutrophication of the water. Preventing this eutrophication is not a task for a single farmer, but all together we can take care of our own environment.
Juan Pablo, you know very well that I love what you do here. You are supplying solutions to the farmers that can help them to increase their yields by reducing their fees, at the same time that they can be more respectful with the environment.
Yes, this is that win.
I will certainly come in the future to extract a little bit more of your very valuable information. Thank you for your time, Juan Pablo.
It is a pleasure. You know you are always welcome here.
Well, as a conclusion, today's farmers are aware that they need to adapt their management to the times we are living, and they, more than anyone, are concerned about our health and environment. So, they are the key for a sustainable agriculture in the future. Fortunately, there are also agri-tech companies like NutriControl that work to offer the highest technology to achieve today's farmers' goals. If you want more information about irrigation systems or fertigation, you can connect Juan Pablo or me on LinkedIn.